Welcome to the Pet Stop. I'm Dr. Brian Voynich. Well, you may not realize it, when it comes down to our health, our furry friends can sometimes deal with the same conditions and ailments as we do. Well, here to explain is Dr. Lenzer, and she's with Crown Veterinary Specialists right here in Lebanon Township. Good to have you on again.
It's nice to be back. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Well, very common problems. Let's start with one of the most common problems.
Dental disease.
Okay.
Right?
Yep, so absolutely.
In humans, over 50% of people over the age of 30 have dental disease. But in animals, it's even higher. Almost 75% of cats and dogs have dental disease before the age of 3.
It's terrible to see, and especially in certain breeds like Yorkshire Terriers, we see sometimes it much even earlier in life than that.
Exactly. Greyhounds, too.
Greyhounds, yeah.
Right. And the number one sign for dental disease can be bad breath.
Oh, absolutely.
So it's really important for our clients to know that so that they can come to us and we can take a look at the mouths and see if there's any signs of infection, inflammation, or painful teeth.
Absolutely. And a really good veterinary checkup is so important. Oftentimes, I, and I'm sure you do as well, do the routine examination of all the 42 teeth in a dog's mouth, mm-hmm. and say, well, my goodness, there's a fractured tooth here. And I would say more than 90% of the times they had no clue.
Exactly.
Because who examines their dog's and cat's mouth
right.
all the time, you know?
Right. And so after they come to us and we take care of the teeth, though, I still will get complaints that people notice that their pet's breath smells badly.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, 1 in 3 pet owners avoid cuddling with their pets because of bad breath. So I actually found this amazing breath freshener. It's called Tooth to Tail Antioxidant Oral Gel. And
okay.
It's brand new. I don't know if you've heard of it or not yet, but it's brand new. And the key word in that is antioxidants.
Great.
And so what the antioxidants do, they actually work in conjunction with the pet's saliva, and they eliminate, they don't mask, they eliminate bad breath. And instead of needing to have to brush the teeth to get the product inside the mouth, you can actually just squirt it on your finger, which is what I'm going to do right here with my dog.
That'll help compliance.
It really does.
Yeah.
And then Jasper can just go ahead and lick it right off my finger.
What a good boy, Jasper.
And so I do this with him once a day,
mm-hmm.
and it really has taken care of his bad breath. Again, in
and he's a teenager. He doesn't look it, but he's in his teens now.
He's a teenager, but I use it with my younger dog, too.
Okay.
So you can pick this up at their website, toothtotail.com.
Great.
It's my new favorite product for
Great.
Sure.
Yeah, because oftentimes, you know, their breath is perfect after a dental procedure is
right.
done, and they're thrilled. And then, you know, if it's not carried through and followed up, you know, if we don't brush or floss every day, our
right.
mouth is going to smell bad too.
And our pets
are
they're closer to us too than they used to be. You know,
yeah,
they're on our pillows, they're on our laps, they're right there.
Yeah.
So we really, I think this is a great. It's nice
great.
To be able to have a way to keep our breath.
Thank you.
Fresh.
Good to see you.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. Here's what we've got working on for tomorrow. And remember, you can always catch the Pet Stop every Saturday and Sunday. That's 45 minutes past the hour, starting at 6:45 a.m. We see some pretty cool animals here on the Pet Stop. If you think your pet has what it takes to be Pet of the Week, go ahead and mail us some pictures or videos to the address on the screen. Or you can email them to thepetstop@news12.com. But be sure to tell us why your pet should be Pet of the Week.